The four standard body types are the hourglass, the pear, the apple, and the rectangular.
Image consultant Wanjiru in the building. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much, Mwikali.
You look fantastic.
Thank you so much. You do too.
Thank you. We'll get to that in a bit where we find out if I am dressing my body type the way it should be dressed. But kindly introduce yourself, what it is that you do and what does it mean?
Okay. So my name is Wanjiru Karaoke, like you have said. I'm a corporate trainer and I'm also an image consultant. Okay. Yeah, I help people become confident in the body they are in and I help them to know what suits them and what is appropriate for them. Yes.
How did you even get into that space? Was it asking you to just see people who are like, you need my help? You need my help. How did you get into this space?
All right. Actually, I'm a trained marketer. That's my profession.
Okay.
But in the year 2016, I started gravitating towards what I'm doing right now. And it's because of a passion I've had all my life. Like, I'm that person, my girlfriends will be, when they want to go for shopping, Wanjiru, come go help me know what to wear. Okay. So in 2016, I was like in a kind of a self-discovery journey. Mm-hmm. And I started gravitating towards the things that I'm passionate about. And I actually started a fashion and style blog, wanjirukaraoke.co.ke.
Oh,
yeah, so it has been a journey. It has been a journey. In the year 2017, now I enrolled for my advanced diploma in image consultancy, that is in South Africa. And here we are. That is how the journey has been unfolding.
So it was passion for you.
Yes.
And then just because it's passion and you love to do it,
yes,
you also enhanced it with getting an education around it as well.
Yes, getting the skills. And then also, even before me going to school, I could be called by corporates, come talk to us on soft skills, come talk to us on this. And I also had now to train with NITA to be a corporate trainer.
Wow.
So for me, it became a full-blown profession.
Great.
Yes.
So we're talking about dressing our body types.
Exactly.
How many body types? Are there even enough? Like, I think there's so many.
But the standard body types,
yes,
the four standard body types are the hourglass,
mm-hmm,
the pear, the apple, and the rectangular body. There are others that are in between.
Yes.
And also the body type is also affected by so many things, because you could be an hourglass, mm-hmm, but then you go and overeat,
mm-hmm,
and find yourself gravitating away from being an hourglass to maybe being a rectangular body shape. So it's also affected by so many things. Our body changes, and you know, as women, our bodies keep changing, our bodies keep transforming based on maybe baby, when you have a baby,
hormones.
When you're transitioning like from teenagehood to womanhood, your body keeps changing, it becomes more defined, and all those things affect our body types, and especially also weight gain also affects our body type. You can find yourself at one point you are a certain body type, but because of body weight, you find yourself now you're gravitating towards a certain body type.
Okay.
Yes.
So you talked about four of them.
Yes, maybe those are the four main ones.
The four main ones.
Yes.
Maybe we explain what they look like so that
exactly,
if anyone is hearing this for the very first time, they understand where do I lie.
Yes, exactly. So the first one we can start with is the pear body shape.
Okay.
Actually, 20% of women around the world belong to this particular body type.
Mm-hmm.
And for a pear, just like a pear, you see the way a pear appears, it's small, mm-hmm, upwards, and then as it goes down, it becomes more curvy or fuller.
Yes.
That is a pear body shape, and it can also be called a triangular body shape, because like a triangle, it's narrow at the top, but when it comes to the bottom, it gets more wider.
Okay.
So what happens to this body type is that they are defined by a very small bust, very small shoulders, and a very small waist, but as you go towards the hips, it gets broader. Yeah, so the hips is their largest area of the body.
Okay.
So that is for the pear.
Mm-hmm.
And then we come to the apple.
Mm-hmm.
The apple is actually the opposite of a pear.
Mm-hmm.
So it's actually like an inverted triangle. You see, the pear was a triangle.
Yes.
So this other one is an inverted triangle.
So you're smaller, and then you get you wider get
yes going up. So what happens with these body types, they are more narrow at the bottom, mm-hmm. but as they come up they start becoming fuller or more curvy.
Okay,
so that defines an apple body shape, where their biggest or their largest area of the body is around the bust area, the shoulder areas.
Okay.
And then we have the rectangular body shape. Mm-hmm. So just like a rectangle, it's just like a rectangle. You see how a rectangle looks?
So the shoulders and the legs are just...
Exactly. Okay. And the thing is, 46% of women around the world belong to this particular body. 46%. Yes. And this most people, like most models, most athletes actually belong to this body type. Mm-hmm. And what happens to this body type? They don't have like defined hips. They don't have a defined bust or even a waist. Mm-hmm. The ratio between the waist and the bust area mm-hmm. is almost the same. You get. And yes. also the ratio between the waist and the hips is almost the same.
Okay.
Because what defines a body type is a body type is actually the ratio between the waist and the hips, and the ratio between the waist and the bust.
Okay.
So for the rectangular body shape, they don't have, the difference is not so much. Mm-hmm. Or rather, the difference between the bust and the waist and the waist and the hips is not too much.
Yeah.
Yes. So that's a rectangular body shape. And okay. then we come to the most coveted body type, which you belong to, by the way, which is the hourglass.
Okay.
The hourglass is the most coveted. Like, everybody wants to belong to that particular body type. And it's because it's defined by a perfect balance. Mm-hmm. And when I mean a perfect balance, I mean the bust and the hips are almost the same. But what defines these people is this, their small waist. They mm-hmm. really have a cinched waist. Mm-hmm. And this is what makes the difference. Yes.
Lies.
Yes.
Okay, so that is the hourglass.
Yes. And around the world, like 8% of women belong to this.
8%?
Yeah. Yes, 8%. Yes. That's why it's the most coveted, because it appears, you see, what happens in our eyes, mm-hmm. we always tend to find a balance. And this appears to be the most balanced mm-hmm. body type with, a certain, like the ratio between the bust and the waist and the hips. It's almost like the waist is the smallest. So it kind of balances the top and the bottom.
Okay. And for this different body types,
yes,
dressing them up is also different.
Very, very different.
Okay,
very,
so that's
very
where we mess up.
That's where we mess up, because what happens is, as women, we want to be in fashion, we want to be trendy.
Yes.
So we always move with the wave. When a certain outfit is trending, that is what we all want. Forgetting, we need to consider what suits our body types.
Absolutely.
Yes. So that's where we go wrong as women. But the thing is, if you know your body type, you will know what suits your body type, you'll know what's appropriate for you, and you will go for that exactly.
So I don't know if we can get into details of what not to wear if you're a certain body type, or
exactly
what to really wear that will help you for a certain body type.
All right, so let's start with the pair, which is the body type that we started with. Yeah.
Yes.
You see, we said they're defined by a small upper body and a wider lower body.
Yes.
So these women are blessed with ample hips, beautiful hips.
Yes.
So they don't need any attention there. So what we'll be trying to do, we are going to be drawing attention away from the hips. And how will we do this? We are going to, you see, the smallest area.
Yes.
That is what we are going to put our emphasis on while we are dressing that body type. So when it comes to tops, these women look very good in ruffled tops, tops that have details, tops that have embellishments, those cute tops.
Yes.
Those ones will really look good on them.
Okay.
And so for their bottom area, they don't need to go like for, A-line, things that are heavy at the bottom.
Okay.
They can put on very fitting pants if it comes to pants. For skirts, they can put very fitting skirts like pencil skirts. Mm. They can go for that. And those things will really look good to them, because they won't draw much attention to their lower body, but rather they will help them emphasize the upper body by wearing things that are, detailed, or things that have embellishments and all that kind of things. When it comes to dresses, these women will look good in bodycon dresses.
Ah, that is true.
Fitting dresses.
Yes.
Yes, because they will, what they will do, they'll outline their, silhouette very nicely.
Okay.
So they can wear bodycon dresses. They can wear dresses that are also Pencil dresses will also look good to them, pencil skirts, and maybe dresses that have, you know, some details, some
yes, all of the vavoom comes over
exactly
here.
Because you see they have a small bust,
yes,
but that's not the attention we want to draw. We want to create a balance. We say the most important thing is creating a balance. So we'll try to balance the bottom and the top by putting more emphasis on the top. Even the off shoulders will look very nice on them because they also have very beautiful shoulders, the small shoulders. So things that are drawing attention to their upper body and drawing away attention from their bottom area.
Okay.
Yes.
That is the pair. I hope Nandika knows.
Yes.
So I think we check out the apple.
Yes. Now, when it comes to the apple, we said it's defined by a fuller upper body.
Yes.
So we don't want to draw attention on their upper body. What we want to do is draw away attention from their upper body because they're already blessed. So they don't need attention there. Okay. The attention now comes on the lower body where they have smaller hips. And the most interesting part is that these people have very beautiful legs. Most of them, majority of them have very beautiful legs. So what they can do is flaunt their legs more by putting dresses that are showing their legs more. Mm. And also what they can do when it comes to skirts, they can go for the A-line skirts. You see, these skirts are more fuller.
Yes.
The A-line skirts, the A-line dresses, they will create a balance. And the other thing that they should do, they should wear more fitting tops. You remember we said with the pair, they need to put details. Mm. These ones, they should wear more fitting tops. But then again, the tops should have like a V-line neckline.
Not all the way here.
And then also, two necklines look very good in these women. Mm-hmm. So they can wear the much more fitting tops. But when it comes to here, they can wear the flared pants, you know, the palazzos, because they will create volume. They will tend to create volume on their lower bodies.
That is genius.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay,
so basically, it's all about creating a balance. Yeah, and because they are bigger over here, so all they need to put is weka madoido huku chini, so that you appear balanced.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Then we have the rectangle.
Yes, we have the rectangle. The rectangular body shape. These people have amazing, amazing legs. That's and amazing true. Hands, very toned, you know, Michelle Obama arms, yeah. So what happens to these women, they should wear like, you know, the off shoulders, the cold shoulders, let us see your shoulders. Mm-hmm. And then also, even for them, they should wear the detailed tops, you know, those fancy tops, those ruffled tops, those those embellished, those ones look very good in them. And then one thing they should emphasize on is always put on a belt. You know what a belt does? We saw the ratio between the waist and the...
It wasn't that.
So we need something to cinch that waist and create the illusion of a small...
waist.
Yes. So they need things like belts or a very nice, you know, structured, well-structured waistline, you know, outfits or even tops. You know, like the peplum tops, which tend to cinch your waist and flow. Those ones will look very perfect to those women. And then when it comes to skirts, they can wear short skirts because they really have amazing legs.
Okay.
And then for them, just like as we saw in the apple, they should wear like, you know, A-line skirts to add a bit of volume, you know, to create a bit of curves, because we saw they're kind of, they're not very curvy.
Yes.
So they can wear the A-line skirts, the A-line, you know, dresses. Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay. And then the final one, which is the... hourglass.
Yes, the hourglass. Now the hourglass, it's the most, you know, it's the body that everybody wants, but it's a very challenging body type. Yeah,
say that again.
It's a very challenging body type. So what happens, these women, you can really make a small mistake and you will appear like a rectangle if you don't wear right. So your waist, that is what we will emphasize on. It's small, yes, but that's where we want all the emphasis, so that balance can be more emphasized. So for hourglass women, they look very nice in bodycon dresses, like you do. I love your dress. Yes, because what it does, it makes you look more structured. Mm-hmm. It makes us see the small waist. It emphasizes your curves, and it brings out your silhouette in a more perfect way. So the other thing that you can wear is straight pants will also look good with them.
Okay.
But always, like, they should gravitate towards wearing a belt so that the waist is always cinched. Yes, the waist is always cinched. And then for the, they also have a beautiful, actually, relatively big bust.
Mm-hmm.
So sometimes you can, don't go for things that are really drawing more attention to it, but just try to create a balance. Try to create a balance by being not so revealing. Just put your emphasis on your waist.
Okay.
Yes. So for these women, bodycon dresses, straight pants, pencil skirts, you know, fitting tops will look very good with them. Yes.
Let me tell you.
Yes.
You have helped us today. You know, you came to rescue us,
uh-huh.
and we have taken it.
Yes.
We have taken notes.
Yes.
And I don't know what your parting shot would be.
All right.
As you come to the end of this conversation, what would be your advice when it comes to fashion,
yes.
and the different body types that
yes.
are there?
So the first thing I would emphasize is for you, first of all, to make the point of knowing what body type you are. And as I said, it can be affected by so many things, body weight.
Mm-hmm.
So you can try to exercise so that you can get to your goal, ultimate body type, you know, because when you exercise, now your features, if it's your waist, it will be more cinched, your calves will come out more. That is if you exercise and, you know, you're eating right, you'll get to know your true body type, because you can be thinking you're a rectangle, but because you've just been feeding on junk, and all the, you know, everything you feed on go to your waist, you don't have a defined waist, so you tend to think you are a rectangle. But probably if you exercised, if you ate right, you could be an hourglass or even a pear. So first of all, purpose to know your body type. And one way you can do that is by eating right and also exercising. The other thing is that you need a tape measure with you.
Allah.
You need this because it will help you know your waist ratio, your waist to your bust ratio, and also your waist to your hips ratio. So what you do if you have
a tape measure
in the inch area, you just go around your waist. Your waist, your smallest, after your navel, that smallest part, the cinched part, that is where you'll go. Use this tape measure and just put it around, write it down, write what you get down. Then go to your shoulders the same, measure it to the right, measurements, ensure that you're wearing, you're not wearing what I'm wearing.
Yes, that we can get a proper size
wear like
of
a
that.
Vest, exactly. Yes. And then your bust area, your fullest area of your bust, you measure it, and then also your hips.
Yes.
Write those measurements down, and I'm going to help you to know how you're going to know. So if, for example, the ratio between your waist and your hips is more than 7 centimeters, automatically you know that you're a pair.
Okay.
If it's above 7 centimeters, if the difference between your hips and your waist is 7 centimeters, you automatically know you're a pair. Yes. And if your hips and your bust area, if the difference is not more than, if the difference is around 7 centimeters thereabout, like if your, or rather the hips and the your bust area is almost the same, has it jachana beyond 7 centimeters, then you know that you're an hourglass. And then if your measurement, if your waist and your bust and your hip area, if the difference is below 7 centimeters, then you will know that there's no much difference. So you'll definitely
rectangle.
Go to a rectangle.
Yes. And you have like 30 seconds.
All right. And for an apple, if your biggest part is your bust area, then automatically you know you're an apple.
An apple, okay.
Yes.
How can people get in touch with you, Wanjiro?
Okay, I'm on YouTube, I'm on Facebook, I'm on Instagram as Wanjiro Karaoke.
Okay.
Yes.
Thank you so much for coming through.
Thank you
Our
so much.
Our time just did.
Okay.
We're going to take a very short commercial break. This is Full Circle with Mwikali. Don't go too far.